students, you're able to see my screen?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Rohan?
Yes.
Tell me how to solve the 11th problem.
First, take the equation of the line ax plus by plus c.
Mm-hmm.
We have to find the slope of it.
Okay.
And then we can use the point slope form.
Okay, tell me ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Slope is how much?
Slope is minus a by b.
Minus a by b. Then what will be the required equation?
So we can use that y minus y1 equal to m into x minus x.
Yeah, y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. If you rearrange it, you will get b into y minus y1 is equal to minus a into x minus x1. So a into x minus x1 plus b into y minus y1 is equal to 0. So this will be the required equation, right? Yes, that's right. Anand?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, tell me how to do this problem. So two lines passing through the point 2, 3 intersect each other at an angle of 60 degrees. If the slope of one line is 2, find the equation of the other line. So what is that you understand? So how to solve this? Make it fast. So there are two lines which are passing through 2, 3. So that is a point at which they intersect each other at an angle of 60 degrees. The slope of one line is 2. What will be the slope of other line? So they are asking the equation of line 2. How to do? You know or not?
No, sir.
Okay, at least I'll give you a hint, right? If two slopes are given and the angle between them is given, what formula can you apply? There are two lines with slope m1 and m2. If alpha is the angle between them, then what is the formula for tan alpha? Mod of
m1 plus mod of m1 plus m2
is not plus. बहुत आई नहीं नॉट हर्षिता
यस सर
टेल मी हाउ टू डू
सो दे हैव गिवन द एंगल ऑफ 60 डिग्री सो टैन
टैन 60 सो टैन टैन व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर टैन अल्फा
mod of m1 minus m2 divided by 1 minus m1 m2
not 1 minus, it is 1 plus. Tan of, what is the value of alpha?
60 degrees, sir.
Okay, why are we doing this?
So that to find M2, sir, we are not given the slope.
That's
of
right. That's right. So 2 minus
M2
divided by
1 plus 2M2.
So what is tan 60? Root 3. Is equal to, whenever modulus is there, I told you one important point. Whenever you remove it, what are we supposed to do?
Plus or minus.
That's right. Plus or minus 2 minus M2 divided by 1 plus 2M2. Right? So once you take plus, you have to solve it once. You take minus, you have to solve it another time. So root 3 will be equal to 2 minus M2 by 1 plus 2M2. Root 3 will be equal to minus 2 plus M2 divided by 1 plus 2M2. Okay. So root 3 plus 2 root 3 M2 is equal to 2 minus M2. Root 3 plus 6 M2, 2 root 3 M2 is equal to minus 2 plus M2. Tell me, what is the value of M2 from the first equation?
2 root 3 plus 1.
That's right.
Is equal to 2 minus root 3.
Okay.
So M2 is equal to 2 minus root 3 divided by 2 root 3 plus 1.
That's right. So what about the second equation? 2 root 3 minus 1 into M2 is equal to, or we can take it as 1 minus 2 root 3 M2. Plus root 3 by 1 minus 2 root 3. Okay. So you have two slopes. You have two slopes, right?
Yes, sir.
So what will be the equation? Y minus y1. Y minus, what is the value of y1? You know the slope, you know the point.
Yes, sir. So y minus 3.
Good. Is equal to 2 minus root 3 by 2 root 3 plus 1 into x minus
2.
Good. So this is one of the equations, and when you use 2 plus root 3 by 1 minus 2 root 3, you will get another equation. Right? That's right. Good.
So we get two answers, sir.
Yeah, you get two answers. There will be two lines. Brithyum, Brithyum A. Surya Seshadri. Mithun.
So the answer, sir.
No, not the answer. Right? Tell me how to solve this. Find the equation of the right bisector of the line segment joining the points 3, 4 and minus 1, 2.
Sir, the right bisector of a line segment bisects the line segment at right angles, sir.
Yes, right side, right bisector means it is perpendicular, and bisecting means it is dividing it into two parts.
Then the points of the line segments are given as a 3, 4 and b -1, 2. Mm-hmm. So according to the midpoint AB, 3 -1/2, 4 + 2/2 is equal to 1, 3, sir. Sir, because at midpoint
formula. Wait. Now tell me.
1,
what is p? 1,
sir, midpoint of AB is equal to 1, 3, sir.
Okay.
Sir, then slope of AB is equal to 2 - 4 divided by 1 - 3, sir.
So how did? So what is the idea here?
Sir,
what is the idea? Why are you finding slope of AB? They didn't ask, no. They didn't ask slope of AB.
Sir, it is perpendicular, sir. Slope of the line is perpendicular to AB, sir.
Okay. So.
It's perpendicular, sir. So the equation, so the midpoint of AB will pass through that, like will pass through the slope, okay, sir. So
no. So why we are finding slope of AB unnecessarily? According to me, why are you finding? With that, what are you going to achieve? Why do we need to find slope of AB?
Sir, it forms triangle, sir.
It's not given,
sir. So, no, sir. Midpoint of M1 is equal to M2, sir.
No.
AP is equal to BP, sir.
AP is equal to BP is accepted, but what is M1 is equal to M2?
Sir, M1... Sir, yes sir, y-3 is equal to 2 × x-1, sir.
What is y-2 is equal to? Tell again, y-2 is equal to y-3
is equal to 2 × x-1, sir. 2 bracket.
How did you get? How did you get this 2 and why did you get it? That is what my question is.
Sir, what idea
came to your mind by looking at perpendicular?
Sir, perpendicular divides the line segment into 2 equal parts, sir.
That's not the answer. This is also a perpendicular. It is not dividing into 2 parts. That's not the answer.
Sir, the M1 into Rohan, M2 is equal to -1. Sir, I used that M1 into M2.
No, somebody spoke before. Who is it?
Sir, Rahul.
Rahul, yeah, tell me.
Sir, it's perpendicular, sir. So M1 into M2 is equal to -1.
That's right. Because wherever you see perpendicular, the first thing that should come to your mind is product of the slopes is always equal to -1. That is the reason why we are finding slope of AP. Yeah, Rohan, you were saying something.
It's the same thing, sir. M1 into M2.
So once you find the slope, it is coming out as how much? 2 divided by -4, which is -1/2. Then what is slope of perpendicular to it? That will be 2. So y-y1 is equal to m × x-x1. So y-3 will be equal to 2 × x-1. Are you clear with this? That is the reason why you got this 2 × x-1. Rahul, can you try the next one?
Yes, sir.
Can you try? If you get stuck, I'll help.
I have a doubt in this question.
You have a doubt, Rohan?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Rahul, you can try or you want me to do?
Sir, you do, sir.
Okay. Harshita, can you try? So, I'll give you the outline. Those who want to try can let me know. So, 3x - 4y - 16 is equal to 0. There is a point which is -1, 3. From here, you have dropped a perpendicular onto this line. If I take this point as P, our work is to find the foot of the perpendicular.
Sir, what is foot of perpendicular means? What is that?
Foot of the perpendicular means wherever this perpendicular is meeting the line.
So that means point P, sir.
A point P is called foot of perpendicular. Okay. So for you to find foot of the perpendicular, again here also you have perpendicular. So wherever perpendicular comes, first thing that should come to your mind, slope of given line into its perpendicular is equal to minus 1. So what is slope of given line?
3/4.
That's right. So 3/4. What is slope of perpendicular then? It will be -4/3. Right. So you know the slope of the perpendicular and the point through which it is passing. So what will be the equation of perpendicular? y minus y1, that is y minus 3 is equal to -4/3 into x+1. So 3y minus 9 is equal to -4x minus 4. So 4x plus 3y is equal to 5. Right? 3x minus 4y minus 16 is 0. Second. So if you solve these two questions, what do you get? So if you solve these two equations, tell me what is the point. Make it fast.
So I'm getting y was -49/25.
Y is -49/25, huh?
Yes, sir.
What is the value of x then?
68/25.
Sorry, I didn't get it. 68/45.
25, sir.
Check the answer. No, I don't know what is the answer. So 68/25, comma -49/25.
Yes, sir. This is the answer.
That's the answer, right? Yes. Then you're right. Yeah. So I hope you understood the method, right? 15th one. The perpendicular from the origin to the line y is equal to mx+c meets it at the point -1, 2. Find the value of m and c. So the perpendicular from origin to the line y is equal to mx+c. Is equal to mx+c will be like this. So perpendicular from here meets the line at -1, 2. The line is y is equal to mx+c. Okay. Find the value of m and c. How to solve this? So this point is 0, 0. If I take this point to be P, can I say OP is perpendicular to line? Yes, OP is perpendicular to the line. So perpendicular means what should come to your mind?
Product of the two slopes is -1.
So product of slopes is -1. So find slope of OP. What is slope of OP?
-2/1.
2 minus 0 by -1 minus 0. minus 2. Oh,
this
sorry.
Will be minus
yeah, yeah, sorry, minus 2. No, no. Yeah, yeah, I'm sorry. I was wrong. So minus 2. And slope of line is m. So slope of line into slope of OP should be minus 1. So slope of line is m into slope of OP is minus 2, which is minus 1. So m will be 1 by 2. Once you get m is equal to 1 by 2, substitute in line. So we know that the line is y is equal to mx plus c. So y is equal to x by 2 plus c, right? But one more point is given that the line is passing through the point minus 1 comma 2. Since y is equal to x by 2 plus c is passing through minus 1 comma 2, you take and substitute it here. So when you substitute it, what do you get? 2 will be equal to minus half plus c, which implies c is equal to 5 by 2. So m is half and c is 5 by 2. That is the required answer. Okay. Is the answer right?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next. If P and Q are the lengths of the perpendicular from origin to the lines, x cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k times cos 2 theta, and x secant theta plus y cosecant theta is equal to k respectively, prove that P square plus 4Q square is equal to K square. So P and Q are the length of the perpendiculars from the line to the origin. Sorry, from the origin to the line. So mark this problem as important. Okay. So what is the formula for perpendicular distance from a point to a line?
Mod of ax1 plus by1 plus c by root of a square.
Yes. Mod of ax1 plus by1 plus c divided by root of a square plus b square. Right. So if you observe, the given lines are what? X cos theta minus y sin theta is equal to k times cos 2 theta. Right. So it should be in the form ax plus by plus c. So x cos theta minus y sin theta minus k times cos 2 theta is equal to 0. So let this be equation number 1. So distance from origin to the first line, what is it? Modulus of minus k cos 2 theta divided by root of, why did I write directly write minus k cos 2 theta? Because in the place of x will substitute 0, in the place of y will substitute 0, because origin is 0 comma 0. So x1 is 0, y1 is 0. So minus k cos 2 theta divided by root of cos square theta plus sine square theta. How much is this value? This is p, right? Which implies k times cos 2 theta is equal to p. Is that right? So which implies cos 2 theta is equal to p divided by k. Any doubt, guys? Just have a look.
So won't
any
it be
doubt?
Plus or minus k cos theta?
Cos no theta. Need, no, because it's, no, it will not be plus or minus. The distance cannot be negative, no? Here, in yes, this context, yes. You are using modulus for distance. Okay, so this is the equation. Similarly, what is the second line that is given? What is the second line given, guys? X secant theta plus y cosecant theta minus k. So again, perpendicular distance from origin. It will be k divided by root of secant square theta plus cosecant square theta. Accepted. So how much is this value? This is q. Any doubt in this? Because ax1 plus by1 plus c, x1 and y1 are 0 comma 0. So k divided by root of 1 by cos square theta plus 1 by sin square theta is equal to k. So you will have k times sin theta cos theta divided by root of sin square theta plus cos square theta is equal to q. Did you understand why I got sin theta cos theta in numerator? Because once I take LCM, what will I have? I'll have sin square theta plus cos square theta divided by sin square theta into cos square theta under a root. So when this goes to the numerator, it will become sin theta into cos theta. Clear? Now see. So k into, I will multiply and divide with 2. Reason being, I have cos 2 theta here. So it's better I have sin 2 theta. So I need sin 2 theta means I need to multiply and divide it with 2. So k into sin 2 theta divided by 2 is equal to q, which implies sin 2 theta is equal to 2q divided by k. Let this be equation number 3. Any doubt, guys? So we know that cos square 2 theta plus sin square 2 theta is 1. So what is cos square 2 theta? That is p square by k square. The sin square 2 theta is 4q square divided by k square is 1, which implies p square plus 4q square is equal to k square. That's what they asked us to prove. P square plus k 4q square is equal to k square. Copy it. Okay. So 17th one. In a triangle ABC with vertices A 2 comma 3, B 4 comma minus 1 and C 1 comma 2, find the equation and length of the altitude from vertex A. So what are the two points? 2 comma 3, 4 comma minus 1 and 1 comma 2. So this is A, B and C. Altitude means what? You're dropping a perpendicular. Okay, find the equation and length of altitude. So if I take this point as P, how to find the equation of AP? So how to find the equation of AP? So for that we need, tell me.
We can find slope of BC first, sir. Then we can use the product.
So can I write like the slope of AP is equal to minus 1 divided by slope of BC?
Yes, sir.
minus 1 divided by, what is the slope of BC, guys? That is 3 minus 3. Is it infinity? So slope of AP is 0. Sorry, infinity, right?
Sir, the denominator is 4 minus 3. 4 minus 2. 4 minus 1. Not
infinity,
not 3 minus.
Sorry. I'm sorry, wait. Yeah. It is 3 divided by minus 3, right?
Yes, sir.
So equation of AP will be like this: y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1. So y minus 3 is equal to x minus 2. So x minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. X minus y plus 1 is equal to 0. So how will you find the distance AP? How will you find the length of AP? For that, write the equation of BC and apply distance from point to a line formula. You will get the answer. Did you understand what I told? To find the length of AP, write the equation of BC and from 2 comma 3 find the perpendicular distance. Okay. So one last problem on this exercise. If P is the length of the perpendicular from origin to the line whose intercepts on the axis are A comma B, then show that 1 by P square is equal to 1 by A square plus 1 by B square. So, solution here is, what is the equation of line? So equation of line is x by a plus y by b is equal to 1. From origin, this perpendicular distance is given as p. Okay. So can I write this line as bx plus ay minus ab is equal to 0? So perpendicular distance is equal to b into 0 plus a into 0 minus ab with the modulus, the whole divided by root of a square plus b square. So that will be ab divided by root of a square plus b square. Accepted. So p is equal to ab divided by root of a square plus b square, which implies by squaring on both sides, we get p square is equal to a square b square divided by a square plus b square. So from this, a square plus b square divided by a square b square is equal to 1 by b square. Now split the denominator to each term, you will get 1 by b square plus 1 by a square is equal to 1 by b square. So that's the required answer. 1 by a square plus 1 by b square is 1 by b square. Is that clear? Is there anyone having a doubt? Is there any doubt?
No, sir.
So this is all about straight lines. So before, see, I cannot teach miscellaneous with the current knowledge you people have. Unless you practice this, there is no point in teaching miscellaneous. Okay. Is there any other conceptual doubt that you have from this chapter? Is there any concept that you didn't understand? Anything? That's it. No doubts. At least answer for this, no? Okay, if there are no doubts, we can wind up. I'll explain miscellaneous in the next class.